Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 656, and today's topic of the lecture is the medicinal properties and some health benefits of Indian podophyllum. Actually, podophyllum is a plant, a herb, and globally there are two sources of getting podophyllum. One is called Indian podophyllum and the other one is called American podophyllum. So here I am discussing Indian podophyllum. The reason is that Indian podophyllum in terms of quality is better than American podophyllum because of its percentage of phytochemicals. Indian podophyllum contains 16% resin, while the American podophyllum, it contains 6 to 8% resins. And in India, it is found in mountainous region, and actually it grows at the height of 2000 feet on the mountain. So that's why mostly this Indian podophyllum, they are found in Himalayan mountain area, one hilly area in Kashmir where the temperature is either zero or in minus, and then in Afghanistan. This is these are the area in Asia, and in America they are also getting where there is hill and height is 2000 feet. And podophyllum, actually plant root is, that is rhizome, is used for medicinal purpose. And from roots, the 16% resins are extracted. And in India, the roots of Indian podophyllum is powdered, and first it is widely used to treat jaundice. Jaundice is a disease caused by liver disorder, means some liver disease where our eye and body will become yellow in color, yellowish color, and even they call it yellow color disease as a common known name in India, and this is because of liver problem. So it is effective in there, and also it is used to treat different type of intestinal worm, tapeworm, threadworm, and some other type. So it is also effective to clear intestinal worm. And thirdly, in India, the ladies, they are also using this drug for abortion in case if they are not interested to carry on their pregnancy, they will use this drug to clear it. It is also used in cancer, to treat the cancer, and some, it is having some anti-tumor effect. And actually it contains mainly that is called podophyllin, or we call it podophyllum resin, and that podophyllum resin or podophyllin is dimer, and that dimer is given here. This is your podophyllotoxin. And this podophyllotoxin is also called podophyllin, or resin of podophyllum. And podophyllotoxin is actually main important, very active ingredient. And the second one is called podophyllic acid. And this podophyllic acid is also rich in podophyllic acid is also important phytochemical, and your Indian podophyllum is rich in podophyllic acid, and the other one is that is ligand, that is podophyllum ligand, and this podophyllum ligand is having 9 different type of compounds, and these 9 different type of compounds I have not given the structure, but I have given the hint, by that you can understand the structure. So this ligand is also very important constituent of Indian podophyllum. So the number one is, and actually they differ only in R1, R2, R3, means this R1, R2, R3, they are representing the different type of functional groups, hydrogen, hydroxy group, sugar group, methoxy group. So once they are changing different type of functional groups, that and the name is given. So the number one is, that is called podophyllotoxin, where R1 is H, R2 is OH, and R3 is CH3. Number two, podophyllotoxin alpha D glucoside, means it is a glycoside, and where glucose is linked with oxygen, and R1 is H, R2 is OGU. OGU means glucose is linked with oxygen, O glycoside, and R3 is methyl group, that is CH3. Number three, it is beta peltonin. In the case of beta peltonin, that is R1 is OH, R2 is H, and R3 is H. R3 is H here. And then number four is beta peltonin beta D glucoside. And this one here, R1 is O glucoside. R1 here, glucose is attached with oxygen. And then R2 is H, and R3 is methyl group. Then number five, that is alpha peltonin. In the case of alpha peltonin, R1 is OH, R2 is H, and R3 is H. Number six, alpha peltonin beta D glucoside. Here, the R1 is O glucose, means glucose is attached to oxygen, and rest of the R2 and R3 are hydrogen and hydrogen. Number seven, dimethyl podo phyllotoxin. And here, in this dimethyl podo phyllotoxin, the R1 is H, R2 is OH, and R3 is H. Number eight, desoxy podo phyllotoxin. PHYLLO. So number eight is desoxy podo phyllotoxin, where R1 is CH3, R2 and R3 are hydrogens, and number nine is podo phyllo toxone. Toxone means keto group is there. So here R1 is CH3, and R2, here R2 is having O, I mean, and that's why it is own is there, and R3 is S. So these are all 9 different type of compounds are there, and these are the most important phytochemicals present in that is Indian podophyllum. So in India, the podophyllum drug is widely used for different medicinal purposes. I have already told you. The one is, that is to treat jaundice, abortion, skin disease, in cancer, for bowel movement, to clear the intestine worm. So it has lot of application. This Indian podophyllum, the botanical source or botanical name you can say is Podophyllum hexadrum royale, and it belongs to family Berberidaceae. Number one, Indian Podophyllum is a plant the root and underground rhizome are used to make medicine in India. And the geographical source, geographically it is found at a high slope of Himalaya. Himalaya is the highest mountain in India. And second, Kashmir is also hill area, mountain, Tibet and Afghanistan. And the plant is perennial herb found at 2000 meters height. And number two, the Indian podophyllum contains up to 16% resins, and American podophyllum contains 6 to 8%. So this is the big difference, almost double the difference of resin contents. And these resin contents, they are actually main medicinal constituents, which contains lot of phytochemicals, and those phytochemicals I have already given, and their structure I have already discussed. Resin contains the active principles, and the active principle resin is called podophyllum resin. Podophyllum resin is the basic principle or constituent of the Indian podophyllum. That is the resin, that is 16%, and it is also called podophyllene. Either they call it podophyllum resin or podophyllene. The main constituents of the podophyllene is podophyllotoxin, and that podophyllotoxin, I have given you the dimer, that nucleus. It has that skeleton, and with that skeleton there are 9 different type of compounds. By changing of the functional groups, that I have already told you. And this is actually a toxin, and they are all ligands. Number three, Indian podophyllum is taken orally to treat jaundice, that is your liver problem. In fever, they give, if suppose somebody is having some running fever, they are given, so it works as antipyretic also to bring down the fever. It is given in syphilis, cancer, and it is also used to empty the bowels, and it increases the bowel movement in your digestive system. So with this, by giving it, it clears, and also it is very good laxative. Kill parasite worms in the intestine, and some women take it to cause an abortion. That I have already told you, that some women, when they are not interested to carry the pregnancy, they abort the pregnancy by taking this drug. That is your Indian podophyllum drug. And then Indian podophyllum has been used as a laxative. That I have already told you is a very good laxative also. And it is applied to skin for removal of warts. So, actually this resin chapter I am discussing thoroughly, and let all the pharmacy students, they benefit. Because once they are going to online or in book, they are going to spend a lot of time to understand. And I have tried to, deliver it is in a very simple language, in a very simple way. So please, my request to all pharmacy students, B Pharm and M Pharm students, to study, and this is in their pharmacognosy, pharmaceutical chemistry, medicinal chemistry. These lot of resins are discussed and lectured for their medicinal properties. So with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.